Hey everybody, how's it going? I'm Andrew, founder of Synapse Productions, where we make mind-bending entertainment, and also co-founder of Cyberfilm AI, where we help you turn your ideas into compelling stories. Okay, so in this video tutorial, what we're going to talk about is how we do the mocap. Okay, so the first thing we'll talk about is the setup. So I have an Alienware Aurora R13 desktop computer, and I use the Xenza Windows Suite by Movella for body performance capture. I use the Scarlett 2i2 to record with two different Sennheiser lav mics, and the standard deviation head-mounted camera for facial performance, along with an iPhone 12. And for hand motion, I use the Xsense gloves by Manus. So what I like to do is make sure that I get all of these things set up and ready to go before the cast come in. Once your cast arrive, you want to make sure that you put all of the straps on with the sensors and then turn them all on. Okay, so the next thing we're going to do is load up the Xsense MVN software, and then we're going to calibrate each of the suits. There's a voice that guides you through each step of the process. You're going to stand still, then you're going to move around to get all of the sensors moving. This is an inertial sensor system. Once everything's calibrated, then you can press record and go through the scene. Another thing that's very important is to make sure that when you are slating, okay.
This is scene 4 from the trailer, take 2.
Okay, so slating, you just say out loud what the scene number is, and then make sure that you clap and do a really big blink, okay? So that when you're syncing together the face mocap data and the body mocap data along later with the audio track, you will have an indication where all those three things line up. Afterwards, once you cut, I definitely recommend that you put into the detail notes exactly which take it was and for which scene, so that when you're going through everything together later, it's easy to find the specific take that you like. The next step after you've recorded the data is to HD reprocess the files. The inertial system's different than Vicon or some of the other optical motion capture systems, where if you jump up for a stunt and you hit the ground, that the sensors jitter a little bit. So the HD reprocessing actually goes through all of the takes and eliminates those things to clean it up so that it's nice, smooth motion capture data for your animation. Just open up the MVN software and then go to tasks. What I like to do is do a batch reprocess so that you can do several files all at once. So just click on that. All right, your input path, you want to choose the folder where all your files were saved. And then your output path, I like to personally save it in a subfolder within that that says HD reprocess. So I just create a new one and then select that for my output path. Reprocessing, you can choose normal quality or HD quality. I always go with HD quality. And then you can also pick parallel processes up to 12 at a time. You can check these other options here, but I like to leave everything else at the default setting. Since this can take a while to do, I like to set this up and get it to start reprocessing over, you know, a lunch break. Once you have the reprocessed files, you can do a couple of things. One possibility is to import the MVN import puppet, connect your animation to that, and then retarget that skeleton to the MetaHuman skeleton. Now, for some reason, the MVN import puppet is designed in a T pose, but the MetaHuman skeleton is in an A pose. Does anybody know why these two people don't talk to each other and make a compatible skeleton? Because it would make all of our lives a heck of a lot easier. So please, MVN, make sure that you get a import puppet that actually works with MetaHumans. Okay, make it in an A pose. Just do it. Now, Caperand has posted on Feeding Wolf's Discord channel a MVN import puppet in an A pose, and he also went ahead and fixed all of the finger issues so that there's no huge gaps on your MetaHuman after you retarget the animation. But I found that it gets very jittery as the characters take steps, and it just wasn't working for me. Great try. Thank you for that. Hopefully the people that produce the software can take that as a hint and go and make something better, all right? The current process that I'm using is to import the FBX data from MVN reprocessed files into iClone 8, and that will export it in an Unreal skeleton and an APOS so that it can be easily retargeted over to the MetaHumans. It's the best process that I've found so far. If anybody has any suggestions as to how to do it better and faster, I would love to hear them. Please, please reach out and comment below about that. I am definitely looking for a better, faster system. Thank you. Thanks so much for watching this video. I hope you found it informative and useful. If so, please leave a comment and also click like. We're going to have a lot more videos in this series on how to take an idea and turn it into a script and then into a feature film using motion capture in Unreal Engine. So if you're interested in that, please subscribe below. Thank you. All right. Now, I want you to visualize moving your leg. Got it. Download that to the LIMP.